Let us look at the mechanisms of protein degradations. There are very specific mechanisms operational in prokaryotic as well as in eukaryotic systems. One of the most important mechanisms of protein degradation is the number one is the lysosomal system. Okay, so you know that lysosomes are derived from the Golgi bodies. They are separated from the Golgi bodies, budding and getting separated. Golgi bodies has got very specific proteolytic enzymes which function in acidic medium. Now, in the lysosomal system is mostly dealing with the extracellular proteins. So there is a mechanism, a receptor mediated mechanism where it will be engulfed. So, and after engulfing, they are destroyed. So this is a kind of mechanism which is operational in the lysosomal system of protein degradation. Then there are two very specific other systems which are working in the eukaryotic system. In the first system, that is known as the calpains. From the name, we should understand that these are calcium binding, calcium regulated, very specific enzyme systems. Now, these enzymes, there are about 14 such calpains that have been identified. Now, these enzyme systems are different from the lysosomal system. So, the lysosomal systems are called cathepsins. Cathepsins. And remember, as we have seen it, they are highly based on, they work in acidic environment. These are proteases working in acidic environment. Now, these calpains, calcium dependent enzymes, proteases, that is one of the system. Another system which is very commonly found, that will take care of about 80 to 90% of the protein. 80 to 90% of the intracellular protein is in the proteasome. Proteasome systems. So these are the general mechanisms for degradation of proteins. Now the question is, how a cell distinguish which protein is to be destroyed? And that is carried out especially by a molecule known as ubiquitin. So this is a protein, ubiquitin. From the name itself, the name was given because it is present everywhere. So it is called a ubiquitin system. Ubiquitin is a protein with 76 amino acids, and it has a molecular weight of somewhere around 8.5 kilodalton. Now this system is able to tag the protein, and that protein will be destroyed. Therefore comes the next question: how the ubiquitin knows that this is the protein that has to be tagged? So in order to get into that, there are several signals present on a protein. And these signals, we are going to see how ubiquitin knows these are the proteins that has to be tagged and it has to be destroyed. In those systems are, in the first one we are going to see is, there are very specific amino acids that are present at the N-terminus of a protein. So at the N-terminus, in the sequences of amino acid decides, and this is known as the end rule. We are looking at how ubiquitin identifies which are the proteins that must be labeled so that they are destroyed. So we have seen that if the composition of amino acid at the end will determine which protein should be degraded fast. Now, these sequences which are present at the end are known as degrons. Okay, degron means for the degradation, if the signal for the degradations are called as the degrons. So, in the degrons, you look at these amino acids. First of all, look at what is written in the green. These are the amino acids. If these are present in the, at the end, it is an indication that if the T half is going to be greater than 20 hours. These are all small amino acids when you look at the structure. If these amino acids are present at the end, if the protein is supposed to be destroyed after 20 hours only. So these are in a way stabilizing amino acid. In comparison, you look at these amino acids. If these amino acids are present, for example, isoleucine and glutamic acid, if the protein is supposed to be destroyed in about 30 minutes. If tyrosine, glutamine, the protein is to be destroyed in 10 minutes. If proline is present, it should be destroyed in about 7 minutes. Leucine, phenylalanine, aspartate, lysine, it is supposed to be destroyed in about 3 minutes. If arginine is present, it is supposed to be destroyed in about 2 minutes. So therefore, these are amino acids that you will find. These are basically basic amino acids you will find in regulatory proteins. That is the point to be noted. So therefore, the point is degrons are present. This is one kind of degrons that will assist, that will determine which all protein should be attached with the ubiquity. In the second kind of degrons, we find is cycling destruction boxes. Cycling destruction boxes are a set of amino acids which are found in those proteins associated with the cell cycle. So if these proteins, if these sequences are present, ubiquity knows that it is to be destroyed. Another kind of degron is what we call, we'll put it the three, is the PEST sequences. In the PEST sequences, as you know, these are the single letter code for amino acid. P stands for proline, E stands for glutamic acid, S stands for serine, and T stands for threonine. Okay, so PEST sequences are present at the end terminus of the protein. Now, what happens to these two amino acids, that is serine, it can be phosphorylated. Threonine can be phosphorylated because they have hydroxyl groups. Once it is phosphorylated, it is an indication that now either PEST sequences must be detected by either ubiquitin, and ubiquitination must happen. So it becomes a kind of an indication for ubiquitination and degradation of a protein. So we are looking at the different signals which are known by the name degrons. We have seen the three kinds of degrons that have been identified through research so far. The first one is a very specific sequences of amino acids, specific amino acids. In the next one, we have called the cycling destruction boxes. And the third one is the PEST sequences. So these are the ways by which ubiquitination happens. Prokaryotic systems, it has no ubiquitin. But prokaryotic system has a very different way of detecting the proteins to be degraded, that is called CLP proteases identifies the prokaryotic system for destruction. Whereas when it comes to eukaryotic system, it has an enzyme, a set of enzymes associated with the proteasome complex, and it is known as the N-recognase. So this will detect in the eukaryotic system, and this detects in the prokaryotic system. Very specific systems are functional in prokaryotic as well as in eukaryotic system. We will be looking at the process in the next session.